Hello, I'm Wanu Newbie, and it's time for more Record Keeper. Today, we have an FF4 event. Kind of themed around Kane, and I actually, like, it does the whole story arc here. I really like it, you know. Friends, betrayal. Soulful Harp is a momentous moment, but a momentous moment is kind of redundant. It's a big moment, but I don't recall that Kane has anything to do with it. He might show up, I honestly don't remember. Snapping out of it, and then regression. Pretty good. But for now, we need to move on. Ah, and the auto host from PA Master. Nice. Okay. So, up first we have the boss rush, the double plus and triple plus. These are all themed around Bale Tower, in a way, because it's just all the archfiends. It's the four archfiends. Which I want to say is when you actually get Kane back. So that's pretty good theming there, once again. So up first, of course, based off the name, Skarmilugan and Rubicante. Skarmi. Good old Skarmi and Rubicante. Big things are, and this is actually a common theme throughout a lot of FF for these fiend bosses. They have counters. And some pretty annoying ones too. Skarmi here does an AoE slow. Rubicante doesn't have a counter, unless you hit him with fire attacks. Ooh, and then the counter is good because it's a full revive heal. But he does have a counter to physicals when his cloak is closed. So fuck it. Just don't. As such, I kind of prepared a party for this. So, the one thing I kind of fucked up here is this right here. Instead of flare, we're going to give the good boy drain. And we're also going to give him auto-reflect. That way we can bounce spells and really not have to worry about the counter hits, because they're extremely frustrating. But yeah, there you go. That's a extremely solid party. The bosses here actually aren't too scary. They're kind of basing a lot of their threat off their gimmicks. So, Curse Eulogy, and then all he actually does is physical attacks, that's it. And then Rubicante is mostly physical, well, mostly fire with one physical attack. And just sort of being rude with his cloak. Oh, he takes reduced dark damage. Well, that'll be fine. Now what we're looking for here is a selfie burst. I know I still have one of those. This is apparently a really good soul break. I haven't tried it out yet, but it's nice. And apparently stacks. Selfie, where you at? Really? Come on. I know I follow a selfie burst. At least like two or three. At least last time I checked I did. Unless they switched. I never followed this. There we go. That took way too long to find. Now, let's talk about the party a little bit. Everybody is kind of just geared out to take advantage of various weaknesses in these fights. With the exception of Rydia, who is kind of more geared out to just not do counters. Though she does have Shiva. Anywho. So, as the fight starts, he is not really going to do too much. And we just kind of want to, you know, bounce spells. You don't need to bounce. Get that Dialga going. Alright, you resist that. Good to know. Not that it'll matter all too much. Now, I don't think you should counter ninja magic, which is why I brought Edge. And yeah, look, even in the back row, we really don't take that much damage. Oh well, in the back row, we don't take that much damage. Oh, also this is just gross. Does have a hit everyone move. Huh. Now, if you wanted, you can also bounce healing magic onto him. That works, and it does actually fulfill the holy condition. Now, Rubicante will probably be a bit more annoying, because I'll bet money he goes into his cloak real fast. Nice, go, go, go. Go. Just go. There's no actual reason to bounce on Rubicante. But you do want to sort of pace your attacks so that you don't actually throw like that right there into his closed cloak. Hmm. Oh, perfect. We'll just finish this fight off now. Done and done. Of course, that is the easy one out of this set. So up next is Cognazzo. Oh, there we go. So the big things here are does of course use ice attacks, has some physical to him, and of course does his whole surging water tsunami thing, which you have to hit with lightning to stop it from happening, so on and so forth. We've seen this before. In fact, we have spent hours on this before. Once again, a slight change to the setup here. I do want to have a reflect on our boy, because Cognazzo does counter any damage that he may take, any magic damage with silence. And any physicals with hold, which is why you actually don't want to go too strong into him with physicals. You could end up with a paralyzed party. That said, this is a pretty good setup. I am bringing, of course, Protectica and Jelga, just to cover all my bases. And why don't we just take a Haska with regen? Almost forgot to get a new picture. Now, the biggest thing about Cognazzo is he can go surging or shell on any turn, and that is a little annoying, because it does prevent a lot of the damage that you may put into him. Now, he does only counter, like, white and black magic, so if you're bringing a ninja, as I am, with, like, Phantasm, you can actually cast some spells into him, as you may want to do, for some extra damage. Pretty much the name of the game, though, is waiting for Surge and then casting spells. I just actually realized I massively messed up with this party formatting, because I don't have a way to dispel, what's it called? Haste, if he casts it. It looks like I should be fine. As always, we want to wait for his next action, and then go. Much like with Ultimate Cognazzo. Nice. This is a fight about biding your time, waiting, and hitting when he gives you an opening. He's just a little slower and doesn't destroy you if you fuck up his gimmick. Oh, he is still vulnerable to ice here? Hell yeah, alright. Let's end the fight, I suppose. Does he absorb thunder lightning now, or just resist it? Who cares, he's dead. you okay there? Alright, and that, we actually get a real nice reward in Lightning Dive. Hell yeah. Lightning Dive is a 4-hit Dragoon move. This is real nice. It's the thing Dragoon needed, really. Like, Dragoon Dive was pretty good. Lightning Dive is gross. Now, Barbaricia. Still has her same gimmick as always. Every turn, she has a chance to turn into tornado form, and when she does, you need to jump to knock her out. She counters most physical attacks about 50% of the time with lightning, which does percentile damage. So that's a headache. Don't use lightning attacks. Don't use wind attacks. She apparently has a holy weakness when in her tornado form, but you don't really want her to be in the tornado form for long, so I'm not really sure if you're supposed to take advantage of that or not. Anywho. You have a crew. So Gilgamesh up top will pretty much Mirror of Equity and then hold and only really do like another Mirror of Equity. I think that's... Is it Equity? Equity? No, that doesn't sound right. Hey Google, help me out here. I've had a streak of saying words wrong recently. This is for you, Stream.
Equity.
Alright, equity. And pretty much, you know, if she takes a turn, he'll do a mirror. If not, just because, like, if she turns into a tornado, he needs to jump on her. Everybody else will, like, you know, do their things. Also, if she doesn't do something. Or if she doesn't tornado. Because, again, you don't want to punch that tornado. That's a bad thing to do. But just in case we do punch that tornado, we have a bunch of death resist accessories here in order to cancel out the damage. Also, hello. I see that the stream count has been going up, so hello. Welcome everybody who has hopped on since we started. We'll take a drink of water before we get started. Also, I'm going to look for a lunatic high here. Hey, perfect. K seems to be an underused. Let me just actually check this again. Oh no, there's Kefka and Kuja. There you go. They say K is an underused character name starter. That was a sentence. Alright, Bari. Let's get this shit started. That was questionable, actually, just starting off with a mirror. Should probably wait for her to take a turn first. Go with moves. You know, full charge might be a little risky here, but let's go for it. There we go. Hmm. I was unaware that she could just, jump right back in. Seems to have worked out alright. Tornado is her, like standard magic attack that just deals a good amount of damage. She seems to be jumping in and out of this way more often than I would care for. Now, if I time this right, full charge should go off right around when... Actually, way faster. Don't go back in. Yes. She is constantly going in and out now. Which is killing me because, I need to hit her with a magic breakdown. Do not go right back in. Oh, thank Christ. I need to be a little risky right now. Alright, this should pretty much end it. That was a little bit riskier than I would have liked. Alright, ooh, holy shit, about halfway through that fight, I started dropping frames like crazy. I'm at about 8% right now. One moment, I need to do a speed test on my other computer. I don't know if I'm still coming through. Tell me if I'm coming through alright. But yeah, holy shit, I'm dropping frames like crazy. Alright. Hopefully that fixes it. Hello. We're back. Hi. Hello. Okay. I've just confirmed. Wow. Everybody's stuck around? Well, most of the people. I really appreciate that. Holy crap. Thank you. Like, legitimately, thank you all. Yeah, that was just a router bounce was required. Everything seems really stable now. I hope it stays that way. Three announcements. It's a, oh, okay, multiplayer. Yeah. Alright, we just had a little dip right there, but that looks like one of my normal dips that happen, because Record Keeper eats the internet and everything like that. Alright, we have a couple of things we need to do housekeeping-wise before we actually jump into the ultimate fights. First things first. This one. Done. Second of all. Hell yeah. I have done the needfuls. I have been waiting for those abilities for so long, holy shit. Alright, so first up, ultimates, Life Eternal, and this is the Dark Dragon. So the big things here to note is he likes to throw out a lot of elemental damage, mostly magic, but he does have a pretty beefy physical attack. That all said, he's weak to fire, he's weak to holy. Also, weak to fire, weak to holy. Also has really high defense. So you actually kind of want to go into this with a magic team more than a physical team. Yeah, so magic is the name of the game. As such, we've built a party. So, Garnet and Selphie will both be putting up our respective barriers. Rydia will be throwing out some really nice spells all over the place. Cecil up top will be tanking for our team. Ramza will be lowering our damage. And, yeah, that's basically how it goes down. No power break really needed for this. While it has pretty spicy attacks, the protect should be enough. There we go. I was hitting the wrong button. We're actually going to be seeing a lot of Cecil in these bonus fights. Yes, the The 13 event started a day later than they had been, so that's why it's still around. And for this, I require the Song of the Sheep. Ah. By the way, I think it drops this event, and if you haven't looked at it, you should definitely take a peek at, whoops, that's the wrong one. I want to say it drops this event. I'll go take a look real quick. I can't bring it up in this emulator, because the way they do soul breaks just kind of breaks it. Yes, it is. Okay. So, Edwards, the Whisperweed Ballad. You should really go look at this Soul Break, because it is ranked number one for, if you don't know the context, most hilarious looking Soul Break. I want to say, if I remember it correctly, it is just Edward in a darkness moving towards his harp, and then he eats shit and then gets up and plays a song. Just walking towards my harp, falls over, gets up, time to sing a song, and just like, it fucking looks hilarious if you don't get the context it owns. Alright. So, if everything is executed, wait, it doesn't actually, right? That's just some flavor text. I better actually be able to use my melee boys. Okay, good. I think that's how they do like the really high defense for this boss. That's supposed to be the reference there, now that I think about it. God, how great would that have been though? Just whoops, can't use your weapons. The fuck? Mog, you failed me again. Yeah, so that's how high his defense is. I forgot to bring death resist. Piss. That was actually a big part of my strategy. Uh-oh. I'll be fine. Hopefully. So yeah, you should bring death resist to this guy. Because a lot of his attacks are percentile. Oh, Dr. Mog did say something about that? Look, I can't read. I'm slightly worried we might not have enough damage here. Now, as predicted, he is kind of going for Cecil. That's actually what we want. Now he's going to be entering the danger zone pretty soon. And at that point, we're going to recast Magic Lore. We're going to recast Sheep Song. And then we're going to cast Meltdown. See, that's what I've been waiting for, right there. Just the good, like, hit me with your magic, see what I do. See what happens. You can't take this. Yeah, I think we'll be fine. Now remember, that is a 20% boost to our defenses. It's pretty good. All else fails, you know? God, Meltdown. What a good investment. Oh, that's magic damage. That's not percentile damage, I think. Yeah, that definitely did less damage. But I think these three hits are gonna spell doom for the dragon. I'm not even hitting any more buttons. That's how confident I am. Nice. God, Meltdown rank 2 would be disgusting. Oh boy, okay. Well, that was the warm-up round. You know, it was easy, but Meltdown did, what, 60,000 damage? Also, you know, synergy magic weapon. You always gotta take these things into account. I always give myself a little leeway, but, you know, you do have to consider some things. Anywho, up next. Also, by the way, this is why I didn't feel bad about fucking honing that thing up. Just give me those orbs. So the Flan Master. I'm not familiar with this boss. I was told recently it might be a GBA boss only. But whatever. Flan Master appears with two white mooses and two black flans. If you defeat the flans first before the Flan Master, it will regenerate them, bring them back. That sucks. Don't do that. It also starts using Ultimate Thundaga after a bit of time. Flame Master is weak to lightning, though, which is weird. And the White Mooses and Black Flans have no weaknesses. However, the Black Flans and White Mooses have their own repertoire, such as big hits across the entire party of both elemental and non. Excuse me. Okay, so exploit the weakness, the lightning, reduce magic, defeat it in 5 turns. Or before it casts Ultimate Thundaga 5 times. So yeah, this is gonna be a thing. We need to fill in some of the gaps here. Now, Riku is going to do a dance to reduce all stats. Cecil up top is going to be tanking a lot of the damage, also casting Shelia, along with Sylphie casting Protect turn 1. And then after that, they're just going to be kind of AoEing all over the place, trying to do as much damage as we can. We're going to be taking a shout to this fight, because we're more melee based than the other ones, just because I wanted to work Riku in here to do a dance. I wanted somebody that would dance and attack. This fight should not last long. That is the intention. I believe the Flan Master only has about 120,000 health, and our goal is to kill them first. That makes sense. Chat does point out that Gyarion is a DS-only boss. Okay, Rydia does have really high magic, though she's not going to be getting an outside boost. She's just going to be going off her own power here. See how this goes. Of course, lightning resist accessory is extremely good in this fight, for obvious fucking reasons. Also, it should be noted that they can follow up any attack with an instant cast Thundara. That's all right. All right. Show me how strong you are, Kane. Yeah, so lightning dive is pretty all right. That's without a 5-star synergy weapon. I just want to point that out. I feel like that needs to be noted. Lightning dive. Pretty fucking alright. Oh, that's the big one. Uh-oh. Stay with me, Kane. Okay. We should be alright. Oh no. Please don't be instant cast. Okay, it's not an instant cast revive. I may still have this. God, that lightning is scary. Fucking summon Chocobo. Just hit it. Just fucking punch it. Chocobo kick! Oh boy, that was scary. That was legitimately pretty scary. Alright, one last one. The Demon Doll. So this one's Calcabria? Calcabrina? So this starts out like a normal Calcabrina fight. You got three Calcas, three Brinas. And they do various attacks, such as elemental, fire, lightning, ice attacks. And some physicals. Aside from that, they will just sort of sit there, you know. However, after 30 seconds, I think on speed 3, they form up into Calcabrina. And that's when the real fight starts. And Calcabrina is. The strength of Calcabrina matters on how many dolls are left. We're never going to see that phase of the fight. My intention is to kill all the Calcas and the Brinas before they form up. This does not have the usual gimmick of if one side dies before the other, they form. It's really just the 30 seconds. And as such, you can kill them all. Just murder all of them. Just get rid of them. God, let's just talk about lightning dive for a second. Like, fucking, how much was that? It was like Yeah, 28,000. Fuck, what a good move. Just kind of makes Dragoons viable again. The other thing to note is that one of them, the ones I believe on the right, so that makes the Breenas are weak to lightning. And they also have higher resistance than the Kalkas. So what we're going to do here is Rinoa and Rydia are going to be throwing out some massive magic damage. Just summons and meteor and what have you. All the while, Yuffie will dance to lower their magic, first of all, and then throw out scrolls to lower the health of the Breenas. I watched a couple videos of this, and yeah, it seems the, like, I'm not just like, oh, watch my crazy strategy of never having to fight Calcabrian. No, that's like the general accepted way that you do this fight, which is weird, which is, you know, I was gonna say weird, but fitting, because that is how every encounter with this boss has ever gone. Just don't let it form. Oh, right, because Syldra is a lightning summon, too. There's Syldra, Ixion, Quetzalcoatl. I don't know what else. I don't know what the other four-star is. Ramu's three. No, Rama's a 3-star. The real question is, when are we gonna get our fire and ice ones? Like, there are three lightning. Where are the fire? I know Japan got that ice one, which sucks that we never got it. Because it was a fucking collab. Alright. See how this goes down. Oh, I didn't mention that Cecil's job in this entire fight is literally to stand in the back row and tank all the damage. Fucking all of it. I might actually, after he casts Shulga, just have him defend. Yeah, that's some good shit. You know, you want some real nightmares, you should look up the Final Fantasy XIV version of this fight. Ah, yes, what if we made these dolls 3D?
No.
Stop it. Get some help. Yes! That's the damage I'm looking for. I did put the Gigas Armor on him. Ooh boy, that actually hits way harder. Yeah, the stun on Quetzalcoatl is why I used it. I chose that one. So far, so good, damage-wise. The nice thing about the scroll is it's kind of rapid fire, which kind of gets it all out real nice and fast. To be expected though, the front ones are lagging a little behind damage-wise. They're taking like kind of half damage. We should start casting Quetzal here. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Huh? Is that a percentile attack? Titan may still be better than that. Oh, here we go. Last one. Get him. Coup de grace, Yuffie. And that's how you kill a doll. It's a good shit, right? there's probably a roaming warrior that you can use for that fight. Anything that does good AoE damage. Maria would probably be really good for that, her burst soul break, because it's AoE and then it gives a buff to yourself and you just keep casting that over and over again. Just remember to faith yourself before casting it. Yeah, that one actually isn't that bad. That was actually pretty easy. True, Ash can hit the weakness, which is pretty fantastic. The only thing I would say is, I don't know. That would take some experimentation, for sure. I don't even know what Kane's accessory does. I didn't even look at that. Let's peep that thing real fast. Oops, that's abilities. Ah, another 30 strength. Not bad. Well, that's it for the FF4 event. That was a nice, like, calming reprieve. One of those words, from the last couple events that have been a little tighter than I would have asked for. Next week, we got the FF3 event that everybody has fucking been waiting for. It's time for the Onion Knight, and I cannot wait. I'll see you next time.